It might be a bit early for blooms, but thanks to the hard work of volunteers here, this garden has been flourishing for the last decade.
I wanted to do something that was living and that would be useful as well as beautiful. I hoped that it would perhaps spark some kind of tradition, or whether it would introduce a specific migrating bird. And actually, that there are some unusual birds now coming into the area because of the orchard. We've seen waxwings. There's been a sparrowhawk last year. That is what I wanted to achieve, and it might have happened.
Down. 10 years ago, this space was nothing more than an old park. Now, with 75 fruit trees, fruit bushes and wild flowers, the orchard has become a centre of the community.
Before, it was just an open green space, not really getting utilised as to how it should be. They've come in, they've encouraged school groups in, they've encouraged other groups in. And to be fair, a lot of kids probably didn't realise that apples grew in trees. They thought they would find them in Tesco's or Sainsbury's or any other well-known supermarket chain. So I would say, in general, they've all got a real buzz out of it. I think they'll get real enjoyment out of it. And I think they're really proud of what they've achieved in such a short space of time.
It's a meeting place. You feel secure in the orchard. People chat to each other in the orchard, talk about the fruit, talk about the weather, talk about whatever. It's also, there are several people who will have a problem with drugs and they come in here and pick the fruit in the summer and eat it. And I think that's excellent.
This garden is one of 15 community green spaces across the city that have won Keep Scotland Beautiful awards. Volunteers here are celebrating after their garden got the outstanding award, the top level.
We're really pleased. We've worked it up from, you know, sort of doing well, doing well, doing well, till this year we did so much better. And that really was because we had engaged more with all the age groups in the community.
They may have an award under their belts, but this green-fingered group have no time to rest on their laurels. With spring fast approaching, it's time to knuckle down and get pruning. Matty Sutton, STV News.